overview of factoring. Now we're going to go over very quickly about talking about an equation of a line. In calculus, we talk about what are called derivatives and integrals. Derivatives very specifically refer to slope. So eventually where you will get to in calculus is that you will be able to find the derivative, and then I will want you to be able to find the equation of that line going through a specific point. Okay, so real quick, we're going to review how do I find the equation of a line. Not only equation of a line, but how do I find slope? Okay, so let's call this slope and equation of a line. Okay, well, as you all remember, what is the standard equation of a line? Well, we have y equals mx plus b. Okay, now what is m? Again, m is my slope. In calculus, we will eventually call this your derivative. Okay, now, how do I find m? If I give you 2 points, can I find my slope? Well, yes, do you remember your formula? M equals delta y over delta x, meaning change in y over change in x, or y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So, alright, and knowing 2 points, I can now find my slope of that line. Now, what if I say, okay, not only do I want you to find the slope of this line, I want you to find the equation of the line going through these 2 points. Well, this is a formula you probably didn't very commonly see in Algebra 1 or Algebra 2, but it is point-slope form. Which is y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Now, in calculus, we're going to have to solve for y anyway, so rather than messing with that over there, I'm just going to say y equals m times x minus x1, and then add y1 on the end. Really doesn't matter, okay? So this is now your preferred form for calculus. You will use this all the time. Okay, so here's what I want. I want to find the slope and equation of the line. So, find the slope and equation of a line going through (5, 3, and 2, -1). So the first thing I have to do, again, remember our formula for a line is y equals m times x minus x1 plus y1. Well, if I want the equation of my line, first thing I have to do, I gotta find m. So what was my formula for m? Well, it's y2 minus y1, or x2 minus x1. Okay, next thing I'm going to do. Alright, let's look here. It really doesn't matter whether I do 3 minus negative 1 or negative 1 minus 3. As long as when I am subtracting, if I do 3 minus negative 1, for the bottom part I have to do 5 minus 2. Okay, so let's look at that. We are going to do 3 minus negative 1 over 5 minus 2. Y's on top, x is on bottom. Okay, minus a negative always makes it a positive, so I have 4. And 5 minus 2 is 3. Okay, so now I have my m. Now I gotta do pick a point. Well, 2 and negative 1 seem easy to work with me, so let's use 2 and negative 1. So, we're just plugging in at this point, okay? So we know my m is 4 thirds, so I have y equals 4 thirds times x. Now, what's my x want? Well, 2. And then plus my y one, which is negative 1. Okay, now, here's the next deal. It may look a little different when you're starting off, but if you pick 5 thirds or 5 comma 3, that's fine. When we FOIL this out and we flush this out, you have the exact same equation. Okay, so distribute my 4 thirds. So y equals 4 thirds x minus 8 thirds. All right, well, plus a negative is just a minus 1. Well, now I have to add these fractions, and you might be saying, Miss Foster, these are nasty, and I'm going, okay, guys, you're gonna have to deal with these, okay? On the AP, yeah, I could just get a calculator and say, oh, let's 8 thirds minus 1, what is that? It'll give it to you in a fraction. You won't have a calculator on half of the AP exam. Standard. So, you're gonna have to add it in your head. Okay, so y equals 4 thirds x minus 8 thirds. Well, 1, writing fancy 1 as a fraction, minus 3 over 3, and that is just minus 8 thirds. So my answer ends up being y equals 4 thirds x minus 11 thirds. One more example very quickly. Again, you can try this one on your own, check yourself at the end, or you can follow along with me. All right, so I want you to find the equation of the line. Going through four, negative three, and negative two, six. So let's look at this. All right, m is, again, what's my formula for m? Well, you should be saying y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, so y2 is, all right, so 6 minus negative 3 and negative 2 minus 4. And again, since I did 6 minus negative 3, I have to do negative 2 minus 4. Remember, y is on top, x is on bottom. 6 minus negative 3 minus a minus becomes a positive, which is 9. And negative 2 minus 4 is negative 6. So I'm left with negative 3 halves. Just simplifying my fraction. I know you'll remember that from 8th grade. So now pick a point. Well, in this case, let's say, hey, Miss Foster, let's do negative 2, 6. So going back to my formula, y equals m times x minus x1 plus y1. Now I've got y is negative 3 halves times x. Now minus x1, well, since we're using 2, negative 6, it's minus a negative 2 plus 6 on the end. Okay, well, let's distribute and add. So y equals negative, whoops, minus a negative becomes a what? Positive. So those are both positive, negative 3 halves x. Right, 2's cancel, so minus 3 and plus 6. Well, combining all my like terms, or CLT it as I like to say, I've got y equals negative 3 halves x plus 3. And you are finished. I'll have more examples to do of these in class tomorrow.